Now, the next point is quasi-static processes. So, this is a very important aspect in thermodynamics and difficult to understand. So, try to understand it, and if any confusion, do ask. So, what is a quasi-static process? A quasi-static process can be viewed as a sufficiently so slow process that allows the system to adjust itself internally so that properties in one part of the system do not change any faster than those at other parts. So what does this mean? In very simple words, I can just say that a quasi-static process is defined as a very slow process that is sufficiently slow. Now, what does the other word means? The other words are that allows the system to adjust itself internally so that properties in one part of the system do not change any faster than those at other part. What does these lines means with reference to quasi-static process? Just look at the example which is given in the next page. Consider a piston cylinder device. Again, this is a very common device. Now I think you must be used to this device, and clear image is now in your mind what a piston cylinder device is. So proceeding towards that what a piston cylinder, now consider a piston cylinder device in which is compressed suddenly. Which is compressed suddenly, so the molecules near the face of the piston will not have enough time to escape, and they will have to pile up in a small region in front of the piston, thus creating high pressure region there. Because of this pressure difference, the system can no longer be said to be in equilibrium, and this makes the entire process non-quasi-static. Now, what does this mean? Assume this piston. This is a piston cylinder device. And first of all, talking about what is reverse of quasi-static, that is a non-quasi-static. And what is non-quasi-static means a process which acts very fastly. That is a non-quasi-static process. So I am taking the first a non-quasi-static process. Consider a piston cylinder device, and here the molecules of gases are present. Suddenly the piston is compressed. So what will happen? The molecules near the face of the piston will pile up. That means they will collect it. So what will happen? A extremely high pressure region will build up. Where? Here. Whereas here will be a pressure but less with respect to this zone. So this means that the system is not in equilibrium. Why? Because here exists a very high pressure and here exists a very a low pressure. Therefore a system cannot be in equilibrium because the values of the properties are very different. So this is a non-quasi-static process. Now what does a quasi-static process means? A quasi-static process means that if I compress this piston very slowly. Now what does the very slowly word means? It means that the molecules near the piston, consider these are the molecules. So if I compress the piston very slowly, so what will happen? The molecules near the piston will have sufficient time to redistribute themselves. That means to rearrange themselves, and there will be no molecule pileup. Means molecules will not pile up near the piston area. As a result, what will happen? Pressure inside the piston cylinder region will be almost uniform and will rise at the same rate at all locations at a uniform rate. Why? Because equilibrium is maintained. So now what is a quasi-static process? That is, if you process in a very sufficiently slow process, then it is a quasi-static. An example which I can also cite you, other than this piston cylinder device, just put up a weight, a 10 kg weight on a balance, that is in the tarazu. Put that weight in a on a weighing balance of 10 kg instantly. Then what will happen? One of the pan will go down instantly. So that is not a equilibrium process, sorry, quasi-static process. So now what is a quasi-static process? Now divide that 10 kg of weight into very small weights. Let that weight be a 10 of 10 gram. So divide 10 kg of weight in equal parts of 10 gram. Now put 10 gram of weight one by one. What will happen? The pan will move very slowly down. So this process is now a quasi-static process because the system is now it moves very slowly and the air near it gets sufficient time to redistribute itself, and the property change nearby will be at a uniform rate. So this is a quasi-static process. Hopefully, you have got the picture of what the quasi-static process is. Now, moving towards the next point. Now, energy exists in various forms. So you know that energy exists in numerous forms, such as thermal energy, electrical energy, chemical and nuclear energy. And moreover, you also knew that mass also contains energy. According to Einstein's equations, E is equal to mc square. So it is an introductory paragraph which is written here. And energy, as you know, can be transferred from into energy can be transferred to or from a closed system in two ways: heat and work. And for control volumes, energy can be transferred by mass flow also. What does this mean? It will be explained a little bit later when you have got some more knowledge about the thermodynamics. Now, it is written that energy transferred to or from a closed system is the if it is caused by temperature difference, otherwise it is work, and it is caused by a force acting through a distance. So in nutshell, it is written that if there is a temperature difference, then energy transfer can be from the closed system, and if not, then it must be a work. So a little bit higher statements, which I think you are not able to understand. Just moving towards the next few lines, and you will get up the statements. What does they mean? Now, first of all, energy transfer by heat. So what does that mean? Heat is defined as the form of energy that is transferred between two systems or a system and its surroundings by virtue of temperature difference. So you also know this, and heat can only be transferred if temperature difference exists. If there is no temperature difference, then no heat can be transferred. Now this means that energy interaction is heat only if it takes place between temperature difference, because of temperature difference. So that means I can say that if temperature difference is there, then energy interaction is purely because of then energy interaction is heat. Okay, therefore it follows that there cannot be any heat transfer between two systems that are at same temperature. So the same words which I said earlier, that there can be no energy transfer in the form of heat if both the systems are at same equilibrium. So this you know very well, that two ice cannot be melted if they are joined each other at 0 degree centigrade, but ice can be melted if it is brought into contact with hot water or steam, because now because there is a temperature difference, and hence energy interaction can take place in the form of heat transfer. Now the next statement is, heat is energy in transition. It is recognized only as it crosses the boundary of the system. So what does this mean? It is recognized only if it crosses the boundary of the system. Consider a hot baked potato. Consider an example. You are taking out a hot baked potato. This potato contains tremendous amount of energy in it, but this energy is heat transfer only. Now look at the statement of somewhat typicalness is being initiated. So I think you must be now little bit tougher side going to. What is it? It is written, the potato contains energy, but this energy is heat transfer only as it passes through the skin of the potato. Sorry for that. That means here is a pictorial view of the what is written here. Consider a baked potato. Okay, now if it contains a tremendous amount of heat, now you can only realize this heat if it crosses its boundary. If it the heat cannot cross the boundary of this big potato, that is, if the heat cannot come to the surrounding air, then you cannot realize this heat. That's the point where what is written here. It is written here that it is recognized, that is, heat is only recognized as it crosses the boundary of the system. So heat can only be recognized if it crosses its boundary, that is, system heat crosses the boundary of the system, then only you can feel, okay, the object is hotter or colder. Now the next statement, once in surrounding, the transferred heat becomes the part of the internal energy of the surrounding. So what does this mean? As the heat transfer takes place to the surroundings, that means if it crosses the boundary of the system and comes to the surrounding air, or it becomes a part of the surrounding air, then it means that its internal energy will transfer to the surrounding or the atmospheric air. Okay, now what is the ambient air? That means the outside air to the system or the atmospheric air. Now this you must be knowing that direction of heat transfer is taken to be from the high temperature system to the low temperature system. That is, heat can only be transferred from high temperature to low temperature, although vice versa process is also possible, but it requires some special appliances. So next statement is, heat flow into the system is taken to be positive and heat flow out of a system is taken to be negative. So what does this mean? That if heat enters into the system, then it is considered to be a positive value, and if it is leaving the system, then it is considered to be a negative value. That means we give the sign plus sign and minus sign to the heat value, heat Q. Q is the standard symbol of heat in thermodynamics. So Q is considered to be positive if it enters the system and negative if it leaves the system, as shown in the diagram. So this is the direction of heat transfer. Now the next is energy transfer by work. So work like heat is also an energy interaction between system and surrounding. So work is also a form of energy as the heat is. Then you can question, sir, what is the then difference between energy and work? So here it is written, energy can cross the boundary of this closed system in the form of heat or work. That means energy can transfer the boundary of a closed system only in two forms, that is heat or work. So this implies that if energy crossing the boundary of a closed system is not heat, then it must be work. Just written in the by passive voice, that previously they have written that if it is a closed system, then energy can transfer only in two ways. That is by heat or work, and if it is the energy crossing the boundary is not heat, then it must be work. Now coming to the next slide. Now heat is very easy to recognize. What does this mean? This means that if a temperature difference exists between two systems or the system and surrounding, then you can easily say that heat is that energy is being transferred in the form of heat. Now how to identify work? So to identify work is a somewhat typical task, and its definition is at present beyond the scope of your this module. So what is the difference between heat and work will be introduced in the next module. Till then, you can rely on this definition that if the energy interaction is not caused by temperature difference between system and surrounding, then it is work. So what does this mean? It simply means that if there is no temperature difference between two system or system and surrounding, and still energy is being transferred, then it must be work. So this is how work is definition is given at present in thermodynamics. Later on, as you go move towards the module second and you study entropy and more advanced topics, then you will come to know that how work is being differentiated from heat. Till then, please rely on this definition only. That is, if there is no temperature difference and still energy is being transferred, then it is work. Now, the next statement is the sign convention of the work is given. It is written as, when work is done by a system, it is taken to be positive, and when work is done on a system, it is taken to be negative. So what does this mean? Although a representation of these statement is done. Now, to give an example, consider a piston cylinder device which is filled with a gas. Okay, now I am assuming that gas is a system, that is I am focusing on gas, so therefore it is a system. If gas exerts pressure on piston and piston moves outward, listen to the statement very carefully, that if gas exerts pressure on the piston and piston moves outward, so work is positive. Why? Because system is doing work on surrounding. Okay, so if a system has capability to do work on the surrounding, then it is taken to be positive. On the other hand, if we compress the gas, if the piston compresses the gas, then it means we have done work on the system, and W, and that means work is taken to be negative. Why? Because work is done on the system. So there are two statements, on the system and by the system, and which you will become more familiar as we do some numericals on this. Now moving towards the next point, path function and point function. Path function is not clear in this picture, although students, it is a path function and path point function. So what are path function and point function? If we take the system from various along many polystatic paths, now moving towards the diagram, as the statements, they have explained the whole thing according to the diagram. Moving to the diagram on the next page. So this is the diagram. So if we consider a system at point 1 and it is moved to point 2 through various quasi-static paths. Now I think you must be aware of what does the quasi-static means to you. So along various quasi-static paths A, C and B, so therefore if we draw it on a PV curve, then the area under this curve is known as work done. Now which you cannot understand few things, that the area under the PV curve, that is the pressure volume curve, is known as the PV curve. So depends, work is called a path function. Why? Because you can see that if I reach from point 1 to point 2 via path A, then it is covering this much area, while if I reach from point 1 to point 2, then it is covering a little bit more area as dotted here, and if via path C, then more area is being covered. So that means more work is done as compared to B. Hence it is said that work is a path function, and a path function is represented by a imperfect differential, and how it is being denoted by a D over a with a cut over it. Thus work done in a quasi-static process between two given states depend upon the path followed, and it is given by this function. It is written as this one rather than this. So we cannot write this format, but we have to write this format to distinguish the inexact differential from the exact differential. A differential sign is being cut by a line at its top, see the special symbol over it, that D is cut by a line over it. Now to convert an inexact differential to an exact differential, we have to multiply it by an integrating factor. In the present case, 1 upon p is the integrating factor. So when I multiply this by p w, then it becomes an exact differential. So students, work is a path function, and so it depends upon the path followed as shown in the diagram. Now the next statement is point functions. What are point functions? Point functions, thermodynamic properties are point functions. What are properties? You know that there are two properties, intensive and extensive, and thermodynamic properties means pressure, volume, temperature. These all are point functions. Since for a given state, there is a definite value for each property. What does this mean? This means if the system is a, for example, if it is ice. So, more clear, if ice is formed, if ice is to be formed from water, then it should be at 0 degree centigrade. So that means it has a definite value. That is why it is called a point function. So the change in a thermodynamic property of a system in a change of state is independent of the system during the change of state and depends only on initial and final state. So what does this line mean? This line means that in case of change of state, thermodynamic properties are independent of the path followed. For example, consider this one. If I say that here the temperature is T1 and if I say here the temperature is T2, then whatever a path I follow, that means either path A, either path B, or either path C, by whichever path I reach point 2, the temperature of the system will always be T2. So this line means exactly the same thing, that change in thermodynamic property of a system is independent of the path followed. Rather, it depends upon the initial and final state of the system. Hence, these are the point function and perfect differential and are generally represented by this value. And at last, for a cyclic process, that means if the system returns to its initial state again, then the value of thermodynamic property is zero. Why? Just look at that. If I again use the same nomenclature T1 and T2 and assume that the path from state 1 to state 2 and state 2 to again state 1, then what will be the change in temperature? Zero. Why? Because the system returns to its initial state again, and hence change in property is again zero. Why? Because T1 minus T1, then it is zero. Moreover, mathematically also you can say that if in this equation I put T1 to T2, now in cyclic process it will be T1 to T1, hence change will be zero. Now the symbol represents the cyclic integral. This is a mathematical symbol. That means if a circle is being drawn at the center of an integral cycle, then it means it is a cyclic integral, and therefore cyclic integral of a property is always zero. So students, I think this must be clear to all of you. Now the last statement is an important one, that cyclic integral for the closed part is always zero, which is explained just now. I have explained to you that if I move from here to here and back, then it is zero. The property, change in property is zero. So students, I think you have understood till now. Now moving towards the next part, that is heat transfer. It is also a path function. Okay, so let's start with it.